יוטט עמוד בית במשנה, משנה, 19b. ביקש להתנמנם פרחי כהונה, מהקין לפניו באצבע צרדה. So if the Kohen Gadol sought to sleep, it's a lot of work and stress involved, so maybe he is about to sleep. So the young Kohanim, the young priest, will snap in the middle of the middle finger against the thumb in order for him to be awake. There are some people who know how to do it. ואומרים לו, אישי כהן גדול, our master, the high priest, the כהן גדול, עמוד ואפג אחת על הרצפה. So, as you know, the floor of the Beit HaMikdash was cold. And those who live or visit Yerushalayim, they knew that it's cold most of the time in the evening time. So, if he will stand up while he's barefoot on the floor, Beit HaMikdash, that for sure caused him, like we're now in the freezing cold weather. So it caused him to be awake and not to think of sleeping. ומעסיקים אותו עד שיגיע זמן שחיטה. And they talked with him, occupied him, until the time of the morning of daily offering. And that way he is up. מהי צרדה? So the Gemara asks, what is the צרדה that we mentioned in Mishnah? What does that mean? In general, צרדה can go in many directions. You see here, אמר רב יהודה, צרתה דדה. So in Gemara Yevamot tells us that there is a צרות, when they have a man that married the two wives, so each of them is like צרה, it's like rival to each other. So now we speak about the fingers, one finger is like a rival for the other. Maihi, what does that mean, the one he called Da? So he said that's applied to Gudal. So Rashi tells us that they use this with the thumb in order to create a noise. Others say that it's a middle finger, that's the Ritva, that they carry more noise. There are others who say that it's the one next to the thumb, but the key is it makes a noise, but they are like one against others, it's like rival, and they compare it, an allegory to rivals of wife. Machavei Rav Huna. Rav Huna demonstrate an example. ואז על קלה בחולי די רב. And they hear the whole Beit Midrash, they heard the noise when he did it. Now, ואומרים לו, and they said to him, אישי כהן גדול, our master, the high priest, הפג שנתך אחת על הרצפה. Come and stand barefoot on the cold floor. Amar Rav Yitzchak, Al Hadat, show us something new. In other words, they try to keep him awake. Maihi, Amrelei, Ahve Kida. They show us the one that you are prostrating yourself, that you demonstrate how the person bend on his thumb until he kissed the floor, but his body is not touched the floor. Some people who are very athletic, they can do that, and then he stand up. ומעסיקים אותו עד שיגיע זמן שחיטה, and they occupied him until the time of the offering arrived. Tana. לא היו מעסיקים אותו, לא בנבל ולא בחינור, אלא בפה, which means they do not use an instrument like violin, right? They just use their own mouth. So even Ura, Nevel, Vechinor, even King David said in the Book of Psalms that those instruments, Psalm 57, can cause a person to awake. But when it's come to wake up the Kohen Gadol, the Marsha said, use your own mouth. The Yerushalmi said it wasn't just that. It was some Kohanim that used this sound like a little background, like a drum, mm-hmm. and the other used the mouth. So all together, they wake him up. What type of song they sang to him? So they said, they quoted Tehillim, Psalm 127, Im Hashem lo yivne vayit, shav avnu bonav bo. So if Hashem not build the house, the people waste their time in the building. So I explained in my book, Birurei HaKlomar Rashi al HaShas. Rashi here said, Klomar, Yizahar ba'avodatcha shetehe l'shem shamayim shetehe l'ratzot. So Rashi here said that it's not just a allegory. The cause, the tachlit, the purpose of the building is for the avoda that did the work every single day, particularly the work of Yom Kippur in Kohen Gadol. So there has to be l'shem shamayim, it has to be for the sake of heaven. Otherwise it's meaningless. So Rashi here used the word klomar to tell us that if you don't do it l'shem shamayim, so it's a problem. I heard from Rav Gordon in the Rosh Yeshiva, on behalf of the original Rav Gordon, the Rosh Yeshiva of Lomza, that he received that tradition from his in-laws. That if you want something to be, to fulfill, to be strong, to be successful, it's go by the inauguration, by the foundation of the building, including marriage life. If you have a good foundation, if you have a good building, you see here in this country, sometimes those who involve real estate, they know that you have building at 80, 90 years old, but as long as the foundation is good, so you don't have issues. It can maintain for a long time. So they all depend upon if it's the strong foundation. Mm-hmm. So in our discussion, Rashi explained Kilomar that if Hashem will not, in our language, anthropomorphic language, feel that it's sincere, is a problem. So be careful that all of your work will be l'shem shamayim, will be for the sake of heaven. Yakirei Yerushalayim, lo ayu yeshenim kol ha'layla, kedei sheyishma kohen gadol kol avara, velo teheh shena chotafto. The pious people of Yerushalayim, they did not sleep all the entire night, instead engaged in Torah study, so the kohen gadol will hear the sound of the noise in the city and will not sleep. So, Tiferet Israel said that they sang before him all these 15 psalms that we do in Shabbos Mincha, the Kuf Kaf, Kuf Lamed Dalet, because this pasuk is within that part. you see it many places that people stay all night in Eve of Yom Kippur and study and say Tehillim, etc., say Mamadot. Tanya, Abba Shaul Omer, Af Bigvulin, not only in the area of the Beit HaMikdash, but also other places, say Yosim, Zecher LaMikdash. So other places, they also do that in order to remember the Mikdash, that that's the way they used to do it. The Orachaim Taf Reish Yutet elaborating that and said that that's the Ela She Ben Ela She Ayu Chotim. So the idea is that there are people who are seen. So 2 points I would like to make. Number one, I heard it once from Rabbi Beryl Wine, He said at the in Chicago, right after the World War II, so you can get properties relatively cheap. So it was a fellow that purchased a land that used to be a garbage area, but they trash it, and he purchased it in a very cheap price, cover it with sand, and build very fancy homes in a very expensive area, the whole area.
On top of a garbage dump.
Yes.
Mm-hmm.
And not long, just several years pass, and people have a huge problem. The smell came out,
mm-hmm.
which means when you're building something not in a good foundation,
right,
this will come back. The second point is a story about the Ger Rebbe, the Beit Yisrael of Gur, Rav Yisrael Alter. I have a privilege to know him in my very young age. My uncle, the Tolner Rebbe, was one of his close students. Anyway, so he asked about the Baal Peor, one of the form of Avodah Zorah, the worship idols in the ancient time. They release, a person release himself with the idol. That was the Baal Peor. So he said, that's disgusting. So why they do that? So he said, the past generation, they worship idols all the times. They couldn't detach themselves from the idol. So therefore, even the time that they need to release, they're releasing themselves with the idols. 24/7, they need to be with the idol. But he said, as a new generation came in, and they don't know much, you know what happened. Then one generation after the next, they know little from their parents many times. So what did they do? They knew only the part that they released themselves with the idols. So they did it, and they think that's the way they're worshiping idols. He said, you see, the elderly pious Hasidim, they used to study all night, and you know, it's like Shavuos night. They study all night, and since they study all night, you know, close to the morning, they want to make sure that they are up while they're davening Shachris, so they drink coffee. The young generation came in, and they see that the elders drinking coffee before Shachris. So what did they interpret it? That it's okay to drink coffee before Shachris. So he said that's the idea. So he said here, shayu chotim, that in order to occupy themselves, people, men, women together, they play, and they come to the act of sin. Amar Abaye, v'iteima Rav Nachman Bar Yitzchak, targuma nahar de'a, de'amar Eliyahu, de'amar le'Eliyahu le'Rav Yehuda Achua de'Rav Sala Chasida. So, either we said that, the Gemara said in the Bava Batra 1:21, that Eliyahu Navi following the Book of Kings, chapter 2, that he never died. So he revealed to them secrets. But anyway, he said, Amrutulei Amailo Ate Mashiach. You always said, why the Mashiach didn't come? So he said, Ve'aidna Yom Kippureu. Ve'ibaul Kama Betulta Benaharda. He said, today is the holiday. And you see in our city at that time, Babylon, in Naharda, there are some people have relations, like some. So he said, Marsha explains, we understand that people sin all year round, but Hayom im bekolot ishmau, today the Yom Kippurim, no one sins. So how come the Mashiach is not here? So he said, the truth is, if you go Hayom im bekolot ishmau, if everyone is Hayom today 100% okay, so then things are different and Mashiach will come. But he said, Amar le HaKadosh Baruch Hu, Mai Amar? Amar le Kaf Amud Aleph, page 20, La Petah Chatat Rovetz. So, in a way, HaKadosh Baruch Hu Melamed Sanegoria, that the Almighty is giving a word of merit to them. He said, people created with Yetzer Hara, with the evil inclinations. So because of that, they sometimes fall in that trap. V'satan mayamal. So we all know that this is the other side. They call it the Satan, Satan. So he is for sure have something to say in regards to sin on Yom Kippur. Amar lei, Eliyahu responds, Satan b'yom ha-kippur, kippur le'et reshul ha-astunei. He's no say on Yom Kippur. He has no right to persecute it or to say a word of something that they did wrong on Yom Kippur. Mimai, how do you know? Omar Rabbi Chami Bar Chama, ha-satan b'gimatria tlat mea v'shishtin v'arba'a ve. If you take the numerical value of the word Satan, it's 364. So it's hey, it's 5, shin is 300, tet is 9, and the nun sofit is 50. So it's 365. So he said, tlat mea v'shinim v'arba yomei it l'reshuta l'astune. Yeah, the 364 days that he can express himself and persecute. B'yom adi kippurei leit l'reshut aleastunei. When it's come to Yom Kippur, it's after the 10 days of Teshuva, and the person understands that his whole purpose of this world is only to serve Hashem. And by fasting and doing all this act of Teshuva, on Yom Kippur, a person forsake all the bad deeds and enter the domain of sanctity. So therefore, the Pirkei Rabbi Eliezer brought that on Yom Kippur, the Satan turn around and be the defender of Israel. Because he see that there's no one sin, so he said, the same way as the angels go barefoot, they go barefoot. The same way as the angels doesn't have occupy themselves with food and drink, they do not occupy the food or drink. The same way as the ministering angels have peace between them, the same way as the nation of Israel have peace. And therefore, Hashem accepted that. So, Yitzchak Bardichever used to say, I wish that I would love the pure, extreme, righteous person, the greatest one, the same way as Hashem loved the worst sinner. Anyway, Mishnah. So after we completed the description that described the walk of Yom Kippur, now we start with the first walk of the day. Bechol yom tormin et ha-mizbeach, every day the Kohen remove the ashes from the altar. That was the outside altar. So there is a two point. One is called hotza'at ha-deshen, and one is called trumat deshen. So we don't compare it, but in a way it's like removing to trash. So he said, when is that? Bekriat ha-gever. So this is a machloket. Later you see if it means that the time of you hear the rooster, or the person that is in charge of the walk in Beit Hamikdash, she called the people. Or samuch lo ben lefanav ben leacharav. So Tosfot hold that the time of the Trumat Hadeshen was all night, before a little before dawn. And the Rambam hold that's right after dawn. But anyway, Rabbi Kiva Iger explains that in the morning you see the beginning of the light and the spreading of the light. So that's the time. But anyway, Ubiyom HaKippurim, but the Day of Atonement, so the Kohen Gadol, Mechatzot, you'll do that from the middle of the night, Ubargalim, and doing the festival me'ashmura rishona, from the midnight shift and onward, ve'lo hayta kriyat hagever magat ad she'hayta azara mele'ah b'Yisrael. So it means the time that the rooster would not arrive at the festival until the temple courtyard was full with the Jewish people who vowed to bring offerings and fulfill the obligation on the festival. So those offerings were sacrificed immediately following the daily offering. So it's already a long line. Did you ever go to a bakery after Pesach? In Eretz Yisrael, I saw it. So the day after Pesach, right, wrong, but you see a long line of people go to pizza and go to that. It's a long line for the offering in Beis Hamikdash. Nanatam, we learned in the Mishnah in different locations in Zvachim 86, Eivarim shepak'u. So we basically bring in the offering at that time, the brought the offering, during the day. So he said, Eivarim, that the limbs from where, from offering, that were forced off the altar by the heat of the fire. מעל גבי המזבח קודם חצות יחזיר ומועלים להם, מועלים בהם. So before midnight they should return them to the fire, and one is liable for misuse of consecrated property. לאחר חצות לא יחזיר. So here you have a מחלוקת between Rashi and Tosfot. Rashi said that it's a regular deshen. Tosfot said that the Truma Tadeshen, it's a total. So which means, for the time that you see a full call. So he said, Ve'ein mo'alim ba'em. So it's not the issue of misuse consecrated property. Nanem ilam, Rav Katuv Echad, Omer Kol Alayla Viktir. So the Torah said, Hi Ha'ola, Al Mugdal HaMizbeach Kol Laila Ad HaBokir. So here the Gemara bring a different way of understanding it. V'katuv echad omer kol ha'layla ve'herin. And one pasuk said that all night and he shall lift, remove. So it means ha'ketzad chalkehu. You should split the night. Chetzio le'aktara. וחציו להרמה. Half it for burning the limbs and half for removing the ashes. Which means the first half a night you have to return it to Mizbeach. The second one it's become Deshen. So the Gemara said in Zvachim Peizayin 87 that the chiyuv, the obligation, is only up to Chatzot. After Chatzot you don't return it. Why? Because it's Gzerat HaKatuv. That's the way we understand from the text. In the Torah. Mativ Rav Kahana. Bechol yom tormin et ha-mizbeach bekriyat ha-geber. He said that every day the Kohen will remove the ashes from the altar at the crow of the rooster. O samuchlo, or close to that time. U'biyom ben milfanav ben ma'acharav. Either before or after that. Ubiyom HaKippurim, what happened to the Day of Atonement? He said, Mechatzot, from midnight, Ubargalim, and on the festivals, Me'ashmua Rishona, from the end of the first watch. Ve'i Salka Da'atach, with page 20b. Ve'i Salka Da'atach, Mechatzot, De'oraitahi. So if you think that the time, the proper time for removal of the ashes is from midnight by the Torah, heichem meked minan veheichem meachrinan. So Rashi said that you don't use the word heichem meachrinan. Tosfot have a different direction, but the key is that how do you postpone the mitzvah to the end of the night? How you go by this festival, the first watch, the first shift? It's basically before the zman, it's before the time. So you can't say that the time of Trumat HaDeshen is from the Chatzot. So since we rejected the point of Rab, So they bring another source for what the Mishnah said, that after midnight, you do not need to return the limb to the altar, they have fire. Amar Ela Amar Rabbi Yochanan. The Torah said clearly in the book of Vayikra, Leviticus chapter 6, Hi Aola al Mugdal Amizbeach Kol Alayla Ad Aboker. So Mimashma Sheneemar Kol Alayla, because they said that the limb of the burnt offering has to be all night. Eini Odeah Shu Ad Aboker. So it's obvious you derive from that it's all night until the morning. Umat Talmud Lomar Ad Aboker. Why you need it? Tien Boker Levokro Shel Laila, which means the real morning. From the end of the night, that's the dawn. So, since the Torah did not specify what is exactly the time of the dawn, so you derive from that a thought that it's applied to a midnight, the end of that shift. Which means, you take those limbs that not fully burned by the fire, so if it turns that they are not fully ready, you return them to the altar. But the idea is that up to the Chatzot you can do that, but after past the Chatzot not. Hilkach bechol yom tomin et ha-mizbeach bekirat ha-gevro samuchlo. Every day they do that when you hear the rooster in the morning. Ben milfanav ben lacharav. So here you said exactly we follow Rashi here, not Tosfot. So because they're not planning to bring the offering the next day because it's a regular day. Sagya, it's enough time to bring all of them, even they don't bring the deshen all night. So you see here that Biyom HaKippurim, Deika Chulsha Dechuen Gadol, Avdil Mechatzot, we are take to our consideration the feeling of the weakness. The Kohen Gadol is weak on Yom Kippur. And therefore, we are doing it from the Chatzot. So we give a chance for the Kohen Gadol to rest for the following day. So it's always said about the righteous, pious people in the past generation in Yerushalayim. They used to go to sleep 8, 9 in the evening and then wake up at the midnight and study. Anyway, so here you see a difference between Rashi and Tosfot. The way that we understand it, that is that something that the Kohen Gadol does or not? Balamau and the Rambam said that the Kohen Gadol does it. Rashi is the issue with that. Ubargalim, the Nefish Yisrael, and Nefish Korbanot. But the festival that many people come to Beit HaMikdash and bring many offerings, Avdinan me'ashmoret harishona. We are doing that from the first watch. Kedektanei ta'ama. The way that the Mishnah explains, lo hayta kriyat ha-gever magat ad shehayta azara mele'a mi-Yisrael. So until the rooster would not arrive on festival, until the temple courtyard was filled with the Jewish people. So it was so many offering that's the considering noi. It's a beauty for the Mizbeach that so many. So there is a point of view that said that they disturbed, some people disturbed the Kohanim for that. So anyway, it was a special scene, a special event when you see so many people bringing the offering and putting the altar one on top of the other. My Kriyat HaGever. What does that mean, Kriyat HaGever, the rooster? Rav Amar Lekara Gavra. That's applied to the person who called, that's the announce, that's the beginning of the war. Rabbi Sheila Amar Kratar Negola. He said that's the Meiri explained, that's much early before the person called people, that's the time that you hear the rooster. Rav Ikla Leatri de Rabbi Sheila. Rav went to a place that Rabbi Sheila was more the Aswa, and people not recognize him there. Lo hava amora lemeka mele de Rabbi Sheila. It was in those days a teacher used to teach, to preach, and it was someone who translated what he said to the current local language. So, for example, if it was Aramaic, he translated the public orator, the speech, to the people. So in those days it wasn't microphone, so you have the translator that have a big voice and he translated. So since Rabbi Shela was there and no one to translate, to speak what he said, Kam Rav Alei. So Rav stood up. So while he was speaking, Rabbi Shela mentioned this discussion of Kriyat HaGever. He said that's applied to a person in Beit HaMikdash that call upon the people for the service. Amar le Rabbi Sheila veleim amar kara tarnegola. He said to Rabbi, why are you translating my word that's applied to the person? You should say that that's applied, translate to them that it's a rooster. In other words, Rabbi Sheila understand both languages. Amar lei, he answered with the allegory. He said, Abuv lecharei zemer, legardaei lo mekablu aminei. So he said that the flute play for non-blaming in his music, but when they play for a weavers, they receive no pleasure from it. Why? Because the lack of the sophistication. So similarly, the interpretation, and that's the reason why Rashi here used the word klomar, explained it in my book. So the legardai, that is the mashal and nimshal, that the legardai, good morning. Legardai, happy Hanukkah. Legardai lo mekula minei. So Rashi explains that the interpretation that I disseminated was accepted by Torah scholar greater than you. You who lack their sophistication cannot appreciate it. That's what he meant. Ki ka'ava kamina leid Rabbi Chiya. When I stood before Rabbi Chiya, in order to translate what he said, umefarshinan mai kriyat hagever, kara gavra. So I said that that's the person in Beit HaMikdash, not the rooster. Velo amar li velo mide. He didn't say anything. Ve'at amart li ema krata negola. I stood before the great Rabbi Chiya, and I was the translator, and I translated that apply to what? To the person. And now you come in, Rabbi Shela, and say that that's applied to the rooster? So the Rambam said in Ilchot Talmud Torah, chapter 4, that one who's translating not allowed to add or change, only if he is either one of the teacher of that person or a rabbi or wise person. But since the Rav was higher than Rabbi Shela, so he was able to do it. So the Nimukea Griv explains that in Yerushalayim, basically, they don't raise roosters. So why? Because the roosters or the chicken in general, they are in the many times in the trash, and then they're bringing ritual impurity to people, and therefore they metame kodashim, they make sacred impure. But he hold that the disputation here is if you have a roosters in Yerushalayim at the first place, or in those families that can use a consecrated item. That's the Nimukei Griv said here. Omar lei, Rav Shila said to him, Mar niu Rav. So he said, are you the one who translated for Rabbi Chiya? Neinach ma. So it's inappropriate for you, such a great person, to be my translator. Amar lei amri inche. Itagart lei putz amrei. He said, because they some said that if you hire yourself to him, come his wool. What does that mean? That since you start the job, you have to complete it. You don't stop at the middle of doing the work. So, Ika de Amri Yache Amarlei Ma'alin Bakodesh Ve'im Moridim. So, if I stop now at the middle of your speech, a translation of your speech, it will look like you take someone and you go down a hill with the level of sanctity. You usually go from the lower to the upper. So, why? Because you bring someone who is less capable to translate. So, therefore, we have to complete. Tanya kvatei derav, tanya kvatei derav shila. Tanya kvatei derav, tanya kvatei derav shila. There are those who go by Rav, and there are those who go by Rav Shila. Tanya kvatei derav gvini karoz. Gvini is the name, general name, of a person who is in charge of the announcement. So one said that when it's time to do the work, Mahu Omer, what did he say in the morning? Imdu kohanim la'avodatchem, ulviyim ledukhanchem. Stand the kohanim for your work, and Levi for their song of the daily song. V'Yisrael le'ma'amadchem. And the others for your ma'amadot. V'ya kulo nishma b'shalosh parsaot. They hear it very far, far away. Shalosh parsaot, it's a three parsaot, is slightly more than 8 miles. That's what they said. Ma'ase ba'agripa samelech. So some say that it was others that was emissary of them. But anyway, the story about Agrippa the king. Shaya ba'bader v'shamash kolo b'shalosh parsaot shebaledo shikir lo matanot. Which means that he heard the voice when he was in a road, and he heard the Gevini announce it, and he sent him gifts. Ve'aval bichen kohen gadol meshubach mimeno. Damar mar, ukvar amar, ana Hashem ve'nishma kolo b'iricho. Said that that's one of the miracles in Beit HaMikdash, that the Kohen Gadol expressed his confession, and you hear it in the city of Jericho. But the Ritva said that that didn't happen all the times, only the time that people followed the way of Hashem, not every single year. Because he basically expressed the confession on behalf of the entire nation. V'amar Rabba Bar Chana, Amar Rabbi Yochanan, Mirushalayim Liricho Eser Parsei. So there's a few versions. How far is it? Tosfot have a different version. Other version. Some say that just hear a noise without understanding what he said. But anyway, they said ve'afal gav de'acha ikachulsha ba'alecha kachulsha. That even the Gevini, it's a regular. It's not a day that they fast. Versus the Kohen Gadol, that he's weak on Yom Kippur. But here is the big miracle. The Kohen Gadol is weak, and he announced, and you hear it so far. So they said another praise word is Ve'acha Yemama Ve'acha Leilia. The Kohen Gadol called was during the day, and Gvini called, it's night. So usually you cannot compare the noise of the night the noise of the day. Why? Because at night you hear the noise. Gilbert will tell you that at night you hear the noise much, much stronger, much better than the day. D'amar Rabbi Levi, mipnei ma'en kolo shel adam nishma b'yom kederech shenishma b'alayla. Why a person's voice at night is not the same sound as the day? Mipnei galgal chama shemnaser barakia. Because there is the sphere of the sun traversing the sky, generate noise like the noise generated by a carpenter. It says kicharash amnaser ba'arazim, the same way as the carpenter, it's sawing cedars, and the noise drawn out of sound. It said v'hai chirga diyoma, but this noise, it's come from the idea that the sun, it's in our language, is like sowing the sky. And if you look carefully, the Sam Eforshim said that you see at the certain time in the morning that you see in the sky a little line. there are Kabbalistic interpretation that say that Galgal Chama, that's the sun, it's protected that we don't hear the songs of the animals, which means the animals sing a song to Hashem at that period, and human cannot take it. Mm-hmm. So therefore, it's for good, for protection. That's the Kabbalah. Anyway, they said V'haychir Gadi Yoma La Shmei. So it's called Ayin. It's called nothing. V'ayinu Dikamar Nebuchadnezzar. That's what Nebuchadnezzar said in the book of Daniel, chapter 4. V'chol Dayre Ara Kelach Hashivim. All the inhabitants of the lands, it's nothing. So it means that it's like a dust. That they have something, but you don't considering something. The Yahweh said that all this voice, it's not physical voice, it's a spiritual voice. Anyway, you see it also in the Rashba and the Ramchal, that they said that the sages, and you see it many times in Daf Yomi, they combine secrets of the Torah while they are speaking. So here he said it is a lot of secret, esoteric part of the Torah that they incorporate with their explanations. And whoever understand. Tanu Rabbanan, Ilmalei Galgal Chama Nishma Kol Amunah Shel Romi. So Romi is the heresy, right? So if it wasn't Galgal Chama, so they hear the sounds of the bustle of the crown of Rome throughout the world. V'kol it says v'yimale kolah shel Romi anishma kol galgal chama. So again, if you got the voice of Rome, you hear the voice of the chama, the sun. Tanu Rabbanan, shalosh kolot olchim misof ha'olam ad sofo. There are three things that promulgated, and you hear it by the entire world. That's the Maharsha, the Maharal explained. Ve'elu en kol galgal chama, as we explained, that he's sawing the sky. Ve'kol amunah shel Romi, and the Rome. Ve'kol neshama b'sha'a sheyotza min haguf. So the sound of the soul at the moment that it's leave the body, which will be audible throughout the world. So the Kitvei Ari said what we explained earlier about the Kohen Gadol. The pasuk said, "Bechol amakom asher azkir et shmi avo elecha uberachticha." In any place that I mention my name, I come and bless you. So the Arizal explained what does that mean, sheazkir. So he said that from the divine providence come out of the mouth of the Kohen Gadol. So that's what we said, Mipi Kohen Gadol, Yotze Mipi Kohen Gadol, when he bowed down, before he bows down, which means that it's heavenly power that come out. So here we talk about the departure of the soul. So Rabbi Tikuchinsky explained in the book, The Bridge of Life, Geshur HaChaim, that in the sphere of the spiritual world, when someone is no longer among the living, the departure, the soul from the body, there is a voice go around the world that announces it, that it's a new soul departure from the body. Again, v'yesh omrim af leida, and they are said even the sound of women giving birth. Kaf alef amud alef, v'yesh omrim ridia. So Rashi said that's a special angel that designated to bring a water to the world, which means that they irrigating the earth, that's called to the heaven and to provide the water. Ubao. So in other words, Hashem is the only one who makes decision if you ever rain or not. This is just the angel that fulfills what is like a robot. Ubao rabanan rachame aneshama b'shah sheyotza maguf ubitlua. So here is again is an act of a little esoteric that the sages ask Hashem that the voice of the soul when departing from the body, people should not hear that, and they are successful to eliminate it. So we see here from this brayta that the Kriyat HaGever is a proclamation of the the Gevini, the temple carrier, in support of the opinion of Rav. Tanek v'tei de Rabbi Shila, now we go the other, Rabbi Shila, ha-yotze la-derech kodem kirat ha-gever damo b'rosho, if someone good the traveler, before the time of the kriyat ha-gever, the rooster, it's a potential to kill by the demons. Rabbi Yoshua Yoshia omer, ad shishne, until the rooster do it twice, ויש אומרים עד שישלש, until there was three times, ובאיזה תרנגול אמרו, ותרנגול בינוני, the medium side. So this bride understand that קריאת הגבר is the crow of the rooster. So you see two different avenues, and each of them have their own school of thoughts. רמב״ם, ספר עבודה, הלכות עבודת יום הכיפורים, chapter 1, ביקש להתנמנם. If the Kohen Gadol sought to sleep at night, so the young Kohanim will snap their fingers before him, and have him stand on a cold floor, Beit HaMikdash. They will occupy him until the time arrived to slaughter the daily offering. Also, we learn that the Rambam, Ilchot Klei HaMikdash, chapter 7. They said, Karosh Shel HaMikdash, one Kohen, one priest, was given the job of ensuring that the temple schedule was observed. So at the appropriate hour, he or one of his people will shout, Arise, Kohanim, to your service, and Leviim, to your platform, and Israel, to your watch. At which point, each person will rush to his respective task. So that was the call, the voice, that's called Karoz in Beit HaMikdash.
Yeah, it's a habit.